She's one of Australia's golden girls, or silver to be precise.
Silver for Australia! Maddie Groves with silver!
But Maddie Groves won't be going for gold in Tokyo after pulling out of Australia's Olympic swimming trials, posting,
"Let this be a lesson to all misogynistic perverts in sport and their bootlickers. You can no longer exploit young women and girls, body shame or medically gaslight them and then expect them to represent you so you can earn your annual bonus. Time's up."
I was very, very sorry to hear that. There's no place for what she alleges.
It's not the first time the swimmer has spoken out, late last year tweeting,
"Can I just say that I definitely made a complaint a few years ago about a person that works at swimming making me feel uncomfortable the way they stare at me in my togs, and I think they've possibly been given a promotion since."
Maddie also claimed a coach made a creepy comment to her, then apologised 15 minutes later. She thinks because a psych told him to.
"We reached out to her in December 2020. We've done it again now. And unfortunately, at this point, we've not been able to have a direct conversation with Maddie to understand who the people involved are so that we can investigate and deal with it."
The sport has a dark history. Allegations of abuse exposed in the Royal Commission into Institutional Responses to Child Sex Abuse in 2014. Since then, authorities insist things have improved.
"And I think everybody in our sport would be quite challenged by the assertion that there is that misogynistic culture. But if there's evidence that suggests otherwise, I would absolutely take it on board."
For now, Swimming Australia says its hands are tied, unless the 26-year-old makes a formal complaint.
"Certainly encourage her to do that, because this is one of the most significant issues and challenges that we and all sports have to make sure that our athletes are protected."
This afternoon, Maddie thanked her supporters, saying her decision was partly due to the pandemic, but mostly because of swimming's culture of ignoring bad behaviour, posting,
"If starting this conversation will save even one young girl from something like being told to lose weight or diet, not going to the Olympics will have been worth it."
Well, Dr. Jenny McMahon is a Commonwealth Games gold medalist swimmer who was awarded an Order of Australia for her research and work around abuse in sport, and she joins us now. Doctor, what was your reaction to Maddie's claims?
Oh, look, I was really disappointed that one of our most talented female swimmers has experienced this. But in the same respect, I was not surprised. I don't think that this was a single or isolated incident in my experience. But I'm really proud of Maddie for speaking out, and I'm also proud of her for putting her mental health as a priority.
Dr. McMahon, Swimming Australia says it's tried unsuccessfully to talk to Maddie about her claims and it has no record of a formal complaint. I feel like that's something that's often thrown up to athletes when they make a claim, is that they haven't gone through the formalities. Is that a good enough response from Swimming Australia?
Well, I don't know the process that Maddie has gone through. She may have very well spoken to somebody within the culture and thought that her claim was heard and it hasn't been acted upon. The issue with Swimming Australia is that they investigate themselves. Sport Integrity Australia says there's an issue with that. A sporting organisation shouldn't be investigating themselves. And also the process of reporting is quite problematic with Swimming Australia. For instance, they have a landline listed on their Swimming Australia website for complaints to be made, and it's not even manned, it's an unmanned landline, so a victim would have to leave a message and then Swimming Australia would have to get back to them. And also the power issues of a young swimmer having to bring these investigations around to the organisation that they're involved with is really problematic.
Dr. McMahon, you're a subject matter expert with your research around abuse in sport, but you're also a former swimmer yourself with a traumatic experience
yes.
firsthand that you had. Can you tell us a bit about that?
So, I love the sport of swimming, and I had really good experiences up until I made my first Australian swimming team. And my own coach didn't make the Australian swimming team, so I was a young girl on her first team that was subjected to daily weigh-ins and skin folds every 5 days. We'd have to line up in our swimwear in front of other countries and other swimmers. I put on weight 3 consecutive days, 0.05 of a kilo, which is nothing. I was a 16-year-old girl that hadn't started menstruating, and my first period was coming at that point. And I was threatened that I would be kicked off the team because I was seen to not be committed. I was absolutely traumatised that everything I'd worked towards was going to be taken away from me. I went back to senior swimmers. I was only a young swimmer at that point, and told them what was wrong. And they told me, some of them told me that they controlled their weight with vomiting after meals. Others said they used laxatives, and others said they used diet pills. So that night, it was the night before my first World Champ swim, I actually tried vomiting for the first time with another senior swimmer helping me. And I didn't get enough up, so I thought, you know, I still panicked. What am I going to do? I haven't got enough food up. If I don't make weight in the morning, I'm going to be kicked off the team. So I went and sat in the sauna for 3 hours. And, you know, what did that do to my performance? I didn't put on weight. I went back to, you know, the original weight, but I sat in the sauna for 3 hours and tried throwing up.
Jenny, we are all just sitting here shaking our heads at what you've just told us, as I'm sure everyone at home is as well. It is such important work that you are doing, and we really appreciate your time and your insight this evening.
Thank you, guys.
We did invite Swimming Australia to come on the show. They declined, but did send us a statement and a link to their complaints policy. You can find both if you head to our website.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.